This video is brought to you by Banks. I've wanted to do an overview iPad guide for a long time, and today is the day. From beginner's concepts, tips and tricks, apps and setups to accessories, I will cover some essentials that can help you get the most out of your iPad. Most of what we'll talk about today applies to modern day iPads that support external displays and the Apple Pencil. Still, owners of older and less expensive models can benefit from most of what we'll discuss here. Let's first lay the foundation. First and foremost, the iPad is not a computer. As soon as you accept this reality, you'll see the iPad as a more focused or less distracting, yet very capable device. The software limitations that most people are complaining about here, for the most part, are an ingredient in the iPad recipe, making it a more purposeful instrument. At a glance, you open an app, maybe two, and stay focused on the task at hand. But there's a lot more to it, and many people don't realize some of those things. Let's start with iCloud and files. If you have an iPad, consider integrating it into a cloud service and start using it as an aid to your primary computer, not just another streaming at home device. The idea is to quickly access Mac files on the iPad. Whenever you need to do something work related, you grab the iPad knowing you can access what's necessary. I'm a big iCloud fan and I keep all my work and personal related files in the cloud knowing I can easily reach them on my iPad. Even if it's not iCloud, you can integrate another service into the Files app like Google Drive. While on the topic of files, I keep my iPad Files app resembling Mac Finder's app. All my files are in a list view because it's 10 times more productive than icons. Plus, I keep all my most accessed folders as favorites in the sidebar for quick reference, replicating my Mac's Finder view. If you want to learn how I use iCloud to run my life, you can check out my dedicated iCloud episode at the end of this video. Aside from organizing files, I use the Files app for scanning documents. This is a big deal for my day-to-day accounting and expenses processes, and the built-in scanner is a must-have. Here are a couple of quick tips to easily manage and grab files. Use two fingers to initiate multi-select and remember the More menu when you select files. Aside from copy-paste, you also have the Archive button, allowing you to create zip files to send around emails, for example. By the way, if you end up enjoying this video, subscribe, because why not? Now let's talk about the home screen setup. My philosophy here is that your home screen should be a single screen. I don't see reasons to use multiple home screens with endless folders that hold apps just as readily available in the app drawer. The purpose of the home screen should be to help you navigate around the most popular apps as well as trigger and toggle actions as efficiently as possible. The home screen setup should be intuitive and not a place to get lost into. I'll put a link to my iPad home screen video guide below and above and only skim through some examples here. On my single homepage, I keep all widgets on the left while my most used apps take the right two-thirds of the screen. The principle is that all multitasking apps, including those that I use all the time, live in the dock. The rest remain on the home screen beside the widgets and are mixed with quick action shortcuts. Regarding apps, I can't tell you which are the best for you since each person's workflow varies, but I can show you a glimpse of my must-haves and why you might want to try them. Starting off with Notion. In its core, Notion is a note-taking app. You can create all sorts of pages, folders, embed documents, and take it up from there to learn to use tables and databases. I started using Notion to run my business. Still, as time passes, I rarely find a reason to use another note-taking app for my personal stuff, so I come back to Notion for that too. It's an app that can be used with team members and expanded a ton, so feel free to check it out. I have a video about it, by the way, so I'll put a link to it in the description below as well. Another app I use all the time is Procreate. If you have an Apple Pencil, it's worth exploring some basic tutorials. There's something magical about its ability to bring out the artist in every person. I also use it with my kids, as it encourages them to draw. Most of my wallpapers are drawn in Procreate, and I love this app. A recent app that became important to me is Apple's Freeform. This is now a built-in iPad OS app that you can use to gather mood boards and inspiration for all sorts of projects. I collect screenshots and images that inspire me to build widgets and wallpapers, but you can use it for pretty much everything else, recipes, social media posts, etc. Lightroom is my go-to photo editing app. Most of the photos I post on the internet go through Lightroom first. I not only use it to apply my presets, but also to do lens corrections and adjust perspectives to make everything look at its best. Microsoft To Do is my current to-do app because it's effortless and quick to insert tasks into. It works across all my devices and it's not limited to Apple products, plus it's free. Okay, let's talk accessories. To get the most out of your iPad, you have to try the Banks Infinity Pro Magnetic Stand. It's not only ideal for a desk setup scenario, but also great for drawing and, get this, meetings. The 360-degree, extremely satisfying rotatable base turns the iPad into the ultimate workstation. The iPad snaps into place effortlessly, ready to be used in a horizontal and vertical orientation. The elaborate foldable mechanism makes the stand extremely portable to store and allows for a third drawing mode. I appreciate the soft padded back that protects the iPad while also keeping it firmly in place thanks to the strong magnets. The design of this stand is very clever. You have the same radius of the corners as the iPad for that fabulous aesthetic look, while leaving the camera array available to be used in a meeting. It's the ideal way to showcase something to someone. Check out Banks Infinity Pro Magnetic Stand in the first link in the description below and use code ThisIsE15 for 15% off site-wide. The next accessory I'd like to discuss is Paperlike. Aside from being an excellent screen protector for the iPad, Paperlike is also a great companion to the Apple Pencil. The unique textured coating provides friction to the tip of the pencil, simulating the feel of writing on paper and eliminating the weird feeling of scratching the glass. Version 2.1 is terrific as it introduces very little loss of quality to the screen while eliminating the nasty fingerprints. Now, even if you don't use the Apple Pencil, the scratch protection and the fingerprint reduction are worth this accessory. Now, having an iPad Air or Pro without giving the Apple Pencil a try is a crime. Now, even if you're not artistically inclined, jotting down notes is worth integrating into your workflow. There are plenty of apps that come with built-in handwriting recognition. With that in mind, if you are a note-taking person and don't care about the pressure-sensitive tip of the $130 Apple Pencil, this Banks pen, at less than half the price, is worth exploring. This is the best third-party pen I've tried so far for the iPad. It connects automatically and comes with a wireless charger to take advantage of the inductive iPad charging, just like the Apple Pencil. Now let's talk about keyboards. Even though you can use plenty of wireless keyboards with the iPad, the best keyboard is the one that is available to you. With that in mind, there are two keyboards that I'd recommend, and both are by Apple. The Folio keyboard is the lighter version of the two, which can swivel back, allowing the iPad to be used as a book. It doesn't have a trackpad though, and it's more resilient to dust and some water drops. The other one is the Magic Keyboard, which weighs more than the tablet itself, floats, and provides the best typing and tracking experience by far. Your choice here relies on the questions: do you need a trackpad? And do you need a keyboard at all? So to use the iPad in a desk setup, aside from the stand we discussed, there's one more thing to consider: the monitor. In most cases, if the monitor comes with a USB-C power delivery port, you are good to go. You can simply connect it to the iPad and it will stay topped up while working on it. If your monitor doesn't have such connection and relies on HDMI, for example, you can consider a USB-C hub like this one from Ugreen. I carry this one with me all the time since it also provides an SD card slot for the iPad. With it, you can also run 4K at 60Hz picture if the display supports it. Second, to run the iPad with extended monitor support, you must be using iPadOS 16.2 or later. This will give you the ability to use the monitor as a secondary display with Stage Manager without having to mirror the display and witness the black bars on both sides. Keep in mind that the tablet can never work in clamshell mode. If you close it with a Magic Keyboard, you won't be able to wake it up to work on the computer, and you're pretty much stuck with a dual monitor setup, like it or not. You can check out my iPad in a desk setup guide in the description below if you want to know the caveats of running an iPad setup. Personally, I don't find the iPad ready for prime time when it comes to using it exclusively in a desk setup. Still, I do see it as a superstar in a sidekick setup where you use it as your best Mac companion. With the help of Universal Control and Sidecar, you can use one set of peripherals to jump between your Mac and the iPad effortlessly. You can use Sidecar to utilize the iPad as a secondary Mac monitor, essentially extending it, or use Universal Control to jump between Mac and iPad OS, just like that. of course, universal copy-paste and AirDrop are here to take full advantage of. When it comes to gaming, the iPad is tough to beat if we talk about performance capabilities and visual experience. Suppose you have a Pro model with ProMotion 120Hz display. In that case, you can run fantastic titles and enjoy visuals better than some portable consoles out there. Playing games on the iPad with touch controls, however, is challenging, so a controller is something to think about. Now, the iPad works with all the controllers out there, like PlayStation and Xbox, but if you want something more smaller, you can check out something like the 8-bit dock controller, which is a great compact alternative. My new favorite controller, as of recently, is the Nintendo Switch Joy-Cons. As I carry the Nintendo Switch with me, I can always rely on popping out a Joy-Con or two and moving to Shadow Blade Plus on the iPad. Check out my step-by-step guide on how I set up a new iPad, and remember to watch my iPad in a desk setup video to find out why I think the iPad is not desk setup worthy yet. Give this video a like and subscribe to the channel as well as my newsletter, and as always, it's been an absolute pleasure. This is E. Over and out.